which we were using in the hope that they would teach us something about the underlying mechanisms of human cancer. It was a bit of a long shot, but turned out to be a good choice. And this particular virus, polyomavirus, causes multiple tumors in rodents. And we were trying to understand how this simple virus with only six genes can cause cancer in cells in culture as well as in animals. And we were focused on one particular gene that makes a small protein when the virus infects a cell. Through some work from other groups, we decided to look to see whether it was an enzyme. It turned out it did have the activity we were looking for, which is an enzyme that adds phosphate to proteins to alter their function. And in the course of studying that enzyme, I stumbled across the fact that it added the phosphate not to the amino acids or protein building blocks that we expected, but a new one called tyrosine. And that was the first hint. There were enzymes called kinases that add phosphate to tyrosine. And we actually, again surprisingly, found a second tumor virus, RAS sarcoma virus, and also had the same activity. And then we were off to the races. We had two different viruses that used the same means of creating a cancer cell. And the field sort of exploded from there. And then a couple of years later, it was shown that these same enzymes are causal in some types of cancer, like chronic myelogenous leukemia. And that was when there was another surge in interest, because here was a targetable enzyme that you could potentially make a drug against that could be used to treat certain types of cancer. Took a long while from there. That was 1979, the first human oncogene that had tyrosine kinase activity was 1982-83, so took another, from there it was another 20 years before a drug was developed that actually targets that first oncogene with tyrosine kinase activity. But it's been, you know, a great ride from then on, since 2001, when Gleevec or imatinib was first approved by the FDA for treating chronic myelogenous leukemia. There are now 39 tyrosine kinase inhibitors that have been approved for different cancers, including some that were developed here.